A microphone duties over to the respected Fox Sports reporter Heidi Andral.
Thank you very much, Jimmy. Thank you to all the members of the media for joining us here today, and of course, all of you fight fans watching around the world on our live streams. If you didn't come here to hear me talk, so I'm going to get right into it. Manny, the last time I saw you, we were in the ring at Dallas Cowboys Stadium with Mr. Jerry Jones. Errol Spence had just won. I kind of was forcing you on who you were going to fight. You had your choice. Then I was in the ring with Danny Garcia, you're with, watching that fight to see who's going to win that fight before you make your decision. You landed on this man here. I know you have said, and you said yesterday, that that was because, you know, a big part of it was his undefeated record. But ultimately, why did you choose Keith Thurman now?
I chose Keith Thurman because I believe that we can bring a good fight to the fans. We can make more action in the ring. That's what I want, because I want to prove that at age of 40 I can still fight to the top with my opponent.
In many post-fight interviews, and one that it came out in was yours. We talked about Twain, that this was your get-back year. You didn't really want to fight for a big fight necessarily until 2020, unless it was Manny Pacquiao, of course. Well, you get Manny Pacquiao, but there was a little rust in that last fight, and your plan was to wait until 2020 for a big fight. So have you had to ramp up your training? Have you had to change your mindset because of that?
No, you know, this is a big fight as far as the stage goes, but, you know, Pacquiao's a little fighter, you know, so it's a big fight against a little guy, you know, I mean, it's a little different, you know. You know, the reach, you know, and he's a veteran. You know, I've dismantled veterans in the past. I've dismantled veterans throughout my whole career. I believe I would have destroyed Manny Pacquiao 5 years ago when he was with Top Rank. So at the end of the day, I've always been ready for this fight. I'm a world-class fighter. Manny's never fought a fighter like me who has the lateral movement, the speed, and the power. He's fought people, you know, that have speed. He's fought people that have power, but not all at one. And he's never fought somebody this young, this strong, this hungry. And I'm coming for him.
When did you get back to training? I know you went to Japan, got married after that fight. You had some personal things you dealt with. When did you get back in the gym?
I was in the gym, 4 weeks ago. You know, just getting some small preparation. I said, I know we're in negotiations for this Pacquiao fight. You know, I don't want to do what I did last camp. I don't want to have to stress about my weight. And I want to get the ball rolling and use the momentum from my last training camp. It's been several years since I fought twice in 1 year. So I'm really looking forward to being back, not just in the ring, but as a truly active world champion. And who better to showcase my skills and talent in front of the whole world? My first pay-per-view fight, Manny Pacquiao, you know. So I'm looking forward to July, and I'm looking forward to being back at the MGM Grand. And like he said, he chose me because it will be an exciting fight.
And most definitely. Yesterday, Keith said he plans to retire you. Your fans don't like that. What do you think of that?
Like I said, a lot of my opponents saying a lot of useless words before the fight. But when we get into the ring, it will change. Same thing happen. And also, most of my opponent is bigger than me, but I beat them all, so...
We didn't beat them all with 7 losses, but okay. But okay.
You are 10 years. What's different about the 40-year-old Manny Pacquiao than the 30-year-old Manny Pacquiao?
I think experience is very important for this fight. Experience is very usable for this fight, and especially fighting undefeated. So I want him to experience losing in the ring.
You said that one of your keys to victory is fight IQ. Do you believe that you have a better fight IQ, a higher fight IQ rather, than Manny Pacquiao?
I do. I mean, I've always seen Manny Pacquiao as a world-class fighter, not a world-class boxer. There's a little bit of a difference. It's how you use the ring when you're in the ring. You know, some of the decisions. Oh, you're going to see. I'm going to trip him up. His feet are going to be so... He ain't going to know what direction to move into. He's going to be hopping over here, hopping over there, hopping, you know. At the end of the day, man, I know who I am as a fighter, and it will be proven come July. You know, I mean, I know he likes to quote Bible verses, so I'll let you know he's getting crucified.
You have been with Manny for 16 years. What have you seen from him of late that impresses you most?
What impresses me is his work ethic. It's unbelievable. He still trains as hard today as he did the first day I met him, and he's dedicated. His work ethic is just unbelievable. It's just work in the gym. And that's why we beat fighters, because we work harder than the guys like that one over there. Yeah, you.
You work harder than me? Okay. We'll see in July.
Okay.
You know, yesterday, Manny, it seemed like Keith making comments about you not getting hit in the face. But considering the style of a Keith Thurman, is that a concern for you?
Well, you say that I don't get hit in the face. It's true, because that's my focus in training, to hit my opponent and to don't get hit. And footwork, hand speed, like that. That's my focus. Of my style, my opponent can easily say, "Oh, an easy opponent, an easy fighter to beat," but when we get to the ring, they will realize that it's not that easy compared to what they say.
What is the biggest difference, in your opinion, in your last opponent to this man sitting here?
Oh, it's different because
yes.
He's a crazy fighter, and I like that. I thought Broner is before the fight is. He talked too much like that. He wanted to be
appreciated
to fight toe to toe with me. And then when we get to the ring, I think double round, all four corners of the ring, and he ran there. This opponent is different. Keith Almighty wants, he like, he's aggressive, and he throw a lot of punches. And. I'm hoping that on July 28th he will stand on what he said, that he will fight toe to toe with me.
Why would you watch this fight?
Like I've been saying all week long, I'm destroying the legend of Manny Pacquiao. His legacy ends on July 20th, and my legacy begins. You know, he's had a tremendous career. He's an inspiration to many people, not just throughout the Philippines, throughout all of America, young boxers all around the world. I mean, he's just done so much, and we all love him, we respect him, and I'm respectfully gonna kick the shit out.
Well, if you'd like to hear more from these fighters, you can tune in to FS1 tonight inside PBC. That will be at 10 Eastern. Manny, I can't cut you off. Go for it.
Yeah, the reason why the fans need to watch this fight is very important, because this fight is once in a lifetime. It's gonna be a best fight of the year.
Pacquiao's last fight.
A lot of passion in the ring. And you hear my opponent say he want to fight toe to toe with me. So let's get it on July 20th. Yeah.
July 20th at MGM. As Jimmy Lennon mentioned, you can purchase your tickets now. And without further ado, I'll hand it back over to the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.